The World Health Organization estimates that 33 million people in the world were living with HIV or AIDS in 2007. That same year, 2.7 million people were infected with HIV, and another 2 million people died from AIDS.
If we keep treating people and we don't do anything on the prevention side, the pandemic just continues to grow and grow and grow, basically.
But there is reason for hope. Ashley Haas and Pat Schlieffert, two scientists at the University of Minnesota, have discovered a potential breakthrough in the prevention of HIV/AIDS.
GML, or glycerin monolaurate, it's a naturally occurring compound. It's generally recognized as safe for human use by the Food and Drug Administration. It's found naturally in breast milk. It's also added to ice cream and gravy, and so anytime you eat those things, you eat it.
It appears, however, GML can do much more than extend the shelf life of foods you buy in the grocery store. In a recent research study published in the journal Nature, Haas and Schlieffert showed GML was extremely effective at preventing transmission of the primate strain of HIV. To understand why it works, it helps to review some biology basics. When our immune systems are activated, they rush T cells to the site of infection to help fight off the attack. HIV is problematic because it's these T cells that the virus is targeting.
So it's counterintuitive here. What we want is to stop those T cells from getting to that place, because if we can keep them from coming into the area, then we can keep them from being infected.
That's where GML comes in. The compound can easily be mixed into a topical gel. When this is applied vaginally, it stops the signaling process from calling more T cells to help fight the viral attack. The call for help doesn't go through, so the infection cannot grow and spread. A small animal study to test this theory came back with promising results.
As an extension of that safety study, we treated monkeys, continued to treat them with GML, and the surprising and great outcome of that experiment was that all five of the animals treated with GML were protected against systemic acute infection.
All of the control animals in the study who were not treated with GML became infected with the primate strain of HIV. The potential of the research is great, but Schlieffert and Haas say there is still a lot of work to be done before planning clinical trials in humans. This includes additional testing in animals and developing methods for dosing and delivery.
We want to be circumspect about the claims we make right now, but we think we have a promising lead here that could add to really contribute to the prevention story.
This is actually one of the most exciting things that I've participated in, because in the first place, I think it can have a major impact on transmission of HIV in the world, but it can also have a major impact on women's vaginal health in general, preventing a variety of sexually transmitted diseases,